Riveting content, empowering your life. Welcome to the Sphere. This episode is sponsored by Houston Housewives of Finance. For more information on increasing your cash flow, becoming your own money manager, and to schedule your complimentary personal finance strategy, contact the Houston Housewives of Finance today at 1-844-700-4463. Looking to advertise? Join the Sphere's vast demographic reach of thousands of people all over the world. Send an email today to advertise@thesphere.tv or call us at area code 832-772-7789. KOG and Company. Are your unique gifts and talents changing the world? Do you desire to belong to a community of unity? Visit KOGpassion.com to learn more about the Unleash Your Dopeness movement.
Well, I want to say...
Welcome back to Intermission. I'm your host, Jarvis Ziggy Newsom. You can find me on Instagram at Ziggy the Lionhearted. And the guy who was speaking at the exact same time, Howard Jerome.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? You can find me at Howard_Jerome on Facebook. I'm also your co-host. That was in the complete wrong order. I'm still discombobulated. So I just saw you post on that, on the... posted you sent up earlier.
Yeah.
And I swear I thought you were one of those bots that were sending out all those links to
random. Oh my gosh. I used to. That's one reason I sort of stopped posting all this stuff on Facebook, because the moment you put something, a movie name in it.
Oh yeah, you're thinking. Like, my hair looks crazy right now. Shit.
But on Facebook, before we get to that, how you doing, man?
Well, I'm good, man. I'm still kind of jacked up from this pre-workout, man.
You're jacked up and I'm pretty sick right now. That's crazy.
I had to do it, man, because everyone around me has been getting sick, and I was like, no, I need to be the opposite. So I took some pre-workout, went and ran a couple miles before coming in here, and that was a bad idea.
Right.
Yeah, dude. But how's your weekend, man?
Weekend was good, man. I did like a crazy 80's movie marathon.
Yeah, I saw you post about that all weekend.
Yeah. And I enjoyed it all, but I also watched some older, like, so-called action movies, stuff that you look at and, like, how did this movie be a blockbuster?
Which one was the worst?
Speed.
Oh, yeah. That's a no. That movie was bad when it
like,
came out.
Even the premise, just some of the reactions in it, I'm like. But we'll talk about that later.
Did you watch Speed 2 Cruise Control?
Fuck it up.
Yeah, that's always been a funny time for me when you go back and look at old Keanu Reeves movies. Because Keanu Reeves like had an awkward transition from being like that teen heartthrob airhead from Bill and Ted to Neo.
True.
And it's like this is a whole new chapter of Keanu Reeves, but like that one.
But isn't this? Let me see. Is Speed right after Point Break?
I think so.
It should be sort of.
I'd say yeah. I think they're like within a year of each other.
Yeah.
But that's like.
Him being an action star, Johnny Mnemonic, and shit like that.
Oh, Johnny Mnemonic. But that was, like, foreshadowing for The Matrix.
Yeah.
In, like, 2008, I think, 2007?
Yeah, but that was completely different.
Well, yeah, I mean...
Like, Scanner Darkly action. Was... actually sort of enjoyed it. It was weird.
It actually might have been after The Matrix, though.
I think it is after the first one.
Yeah.
Because that was one of Robert Downey's first comeback movies.
Yeah, see, that's funny that they were in a movie together as... in the comeback
here, they both
hit some really, really shit times.
Yeah, movies. They really did. But you know, his shit times was more self-induced.
For sure.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, also Keanu Reeves had issues too, because he was like losing people, friends, and all that stuff. And I think he lost like a girlfriend or a wife or something.
Yeah, I think she passed away.
Yeah. So you know, they both kind of were going through some hard stuff in the personal realm of things.
Yeah.
And now. Oh, two of my favorite actors now.
Dude.
You know who else is going through shit around the time? Charlie Sheen, man.
He's still going through shit, though.
Yeah. Sometimes times, but that shit takes you down.
Right. Yeah, he was always going to do shit, though.
Yo, what was that movie that he was in? Ferris Bueller's Day Out?
Where he was high?
Oh, yeah. He looked crazy in that movie.
Yeah.
Bloodshot eyes. Look like a zombie.
Yeah. So, on Facebook Live, I asked the question, because I'm not finna watch both of these over the summer. I know some of you was like, they're two totally different shows, and you can make them work. And I'm just like, I'm not.
Looks like we're having some technical.
Okay.
With my mic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's some technical difficulties with the mics. Microphone check. Microphone check, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Hello.
But I asked the question, which show for me to watch would you pick? Queen Sugar or This Is Us? Simple question. If you can't answer it, don't comment.
There's never any simple questions on the internet, man. Nothing is simple these days.
Oh my gosh, it's just like they're two different shows. I know that. I'm asking you because these are two of the shows that I see up on my timeline the most when they're on.
Yeah,
everybody's talking about them, and it might end up being Queen Sugar for me.
So, I personally would say just go Queen Sugar, period, just because This Is It. It's supposed to be like just a really sad show.
Really,
and I've seen
sad,
episodes
really
and
emotional.
Like, I don't care how good a show is. I personally do not like watching sad movies and sad TV shows. I'm in it for the escapism of it.
I mean, I can take it. I can take a sad movie or a sad show, but and it's just overly emotional.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just like, now everyone's like, "This is so going to make you cry," and I'm like, I'm the guy who cheered when Hannibal Lecter took the head off on Hannibal. I'm like, I'm not going necessarily going to be overly emotional with stuff like this. So
these might not be movies for you. TV shows for you to watch, period.
But I want to do it for, because I know a lot of our audience watches these shows.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, I'm going to do one. I'm not doing both. And it's probably going to be Queen Sugar.
I decided that I'm going to watch, I was telling you about it right before the show started, some trash TV, because I need something a little bit dumb to watch. So I'm going to flip over to X's on the Beach.
Yeah.
That show looks ridiculous, man. But, so I got hit over the weekend about Badlands. I know you were really big on
Into
Badlands.
Into the Badlands, yeah.
So, I don't know what's going on, but over the weekend, I think like 5 or 6 people mentioned Into the Badlands to me. So, I'm going to finally go out there and watch it, so I should have an opinion on that soon.
You know, it's the story is not the greatest. You know, it's probably to do with a little bit stronger story.
See, but nobody mentioned the story. Everybody was like,
the choreography.
That's all they're talking about.
The choreography is badass, especially the first season.
Mm-hmm.
Second season falls off a little bit, but I heard they got a little bit better, and Daniel Wu took over the choreography for the third season.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm definitely up for that, you know. Probably wait till it closes out and binge watch that.
Yeah. I know Billions is rounding out towards an end of their season soon, so I'll be catching up on that. And what's that other one? Oh, I keep forgetting. Legion.
I haven't heard much about it this season.
I mean, we didn't hear much about it when it first came out, like that first season. I mean, we talked about it, but most people didn't see it because, I mean, we're being real, it's kind of a weird show.
Nah, ain't no kind of. Yeah. It's a weird show.
But, I mean,
Beautifully shot,
action-packed. The story is really in-depth.
Yeah.
But as far as, like, hero movies go and all that, they pay more attention to character development and backstories.
Yeah.
Than they do actually leaning on powers and all that good stuff. So it's right. A different kind of, I wouldn't say it's a hero fic, but a comic book flick or yeah. Comic book TV show.
If you don't know, Legion on FX is based off a character in Marvel's comics X-Men. Professor X had a son named David, who has multiple personalities. In a comic book, he has a different power with each personality. I'm not sure if the show is exploring that or not.
So they're more so, at least in the first season, is that he doesn't really have control over his powers.
Right.
But he also doesn't have control over his personalities.
True.
And so he falls into these different episodes. And powers end up manifesting themselves, and also when he gets like booted out of his body and all this kind of stuff with that there's like a parasite in him.
Yeah, the Shadow King.
Yeah. So in that first season, because he's battling with that,
yeah.
we don't really know which personalities he's in control of, which one of the Shadow Kings is actually in control of. So yeah. I'm hoping to see in the second season when I actually go ahead and binge on this to see how that plays out. So yeah. I should be able to report back more on that.
I'm liking Westworld right now. This second season is pretty dope. Like, I know it's hard to get into in the beginning. I know it's a little slow. Mm-hmm. And even I can admit that. But this second season of Westworld is good because they're showing more of the other artificial settings.
Yeah.
Like, I think there was one that's in the Renaissance.
Ooh, nice.
So they're able to go because they think now this virus is going to affect all the robots.
Mm-hmm.
So they're trying to see where to go, and some of these robots are now self-aware.
Dude, that's pretty interesting, too, to have that, especially with all this stuff with Google and their AI that's coming out. And
right. Like, that's what makes it, like, konnichiwa, Clinton. Thanks for joining us, man. I see you, Jasmine. I know it depends on the type of person you are as far as Queen Sugar and This Is Us. That's why I'm going with Queen Sugar.
But, yeah, so with Westworld, I mean, with it running so parallel to what's going on, I mean, that could be kind of creepy a little
it's
bit.
It's almost, you know, like Black Mirror and stuff, like a lot of stuff.
Well, see, with Black Mirror, though, like, Black Mirror is so plausible to happen, like, in today's right. day and age. And there's actually another Netflix production called Anon, or Anon, that has five Anon, Owens
yeah,
in
it's,
it.
Yeah, it's a movie.
Yeah. Yeah. It got some shit reviews, but they were doing something similar with being able to program and hack into somebody's brain and all this stuff. So it kind of played out like a poor episode of Black Mirror. But
gotcha.
I don't know. Sci-fi is really taking an interesting turn right now.
It is. Junius, what's up, man? Thanks for joining us as usual, man. One of our regular guys. But it's because you can go so many directions with sci-fi, I think.
But the thing that for me is that I find fascinating about it right now is that it's there's so many advances that are happening in real life. To see these shows talk about it and then talk about a subject like AI. Mm-hmm. So when we had
iRobot.
No, not even that, dude. The one that was about the Turing test, Ex Machina.
Yeah.
You have Ex Machina come out, and then next thing we know, we're having all this advanced AI coming out with Google and then being able to have AI that can have a real life in real time conversation with you and not really know if it's a person or not.
Life imitating art, man.
That's just wild. There was another show that I was thinking of that I was really into, but I'm more excited about Deadpool coming out this week, though.
Oh, yeah, I'm definitely excited. Clinton, you said Google did a bad thing. Should I quote Jeff Goldblum? Go ahead.
Yeah, quote Jeff Goldblum.
Yes.
First off,
anytime you get a chance to quote Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah, he had a food truck in Australia called, I think it was called Jeff's Sausages or Goldblum Sausages, and he was selling sausages out of a food truck in Australia like a couple months back.
I just want him to do my voicemail reading. Oh, okay. We got Jarvis's phone here.
That dude, man. I want to see him in.
Well, he's in that movie you talked about.
Which one?
Hotel Artemis.
Yeah. But I want to see him being interviewed by Jerry Seinfeld in Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee.
That would be dope.
That would be interesting to see. Like, see him. Because I think he's also in that same vein of other actors. They're not playing a role. They're just being themselves. Just reading some lines.
Like Christopher Walken.
Yeah. Or old boy who plays Yondu. I always forget his name.
Michael Rooker.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. But right now, this portion of the show is sponsored by Houston Housewives of Finance. Did you know that only 4 states in the United States offer financial education? 33% of Americans don't pay their bills on time. 39% carry credit card debt from month to month. And 39% of adults say they don't have enough savings. Don't become one of these statistics. Let Houston Housewives of Finance advise you on increasing your cash flow and becoming your own money manager by scheduling your personal, complimentary, personal financial strategy. Contact Houston Housewives of Finance today at 1-844-700-4463 or email us at info@HoustonHousewivesOfFinance.com. Ask us how you can participate in a complimentary financial literacy workshop near you. Houston Housewives of Finance are the new faces of the new age of financial services. You don't know how hard it is trying to do that with a stuffy nose.
I'm reading on Queen Sugar real quick. I actually realized I don't know anything about this show.
I think it's like the father dies and... Oh, hello, Erlene. Thanks for joining us. Erlene, since you're joining us, which one would you choose between This Is Us and Queen Sugar? If you had to pick one show for me to watch, because I'm gonna watch this show. Which one would you choose? But from what, like I said, I think it's the father dies and the kids come home to the estate. And now it's a lot of stuff that was going on around the estate that they didn't realize.
Gotcha. Yeah, I got distracted because that for some reason, I don't know how this did it, but it made me want to look up American Gods when season 2 comes out.
Next year.
Why? That makes no sense.
No, they lost their showrunners.
Oh.
So now they just got some new showrunners, so now they've started back shooting.
That's crazy. I don't know how they did that.
Erlene says, This Is Us.
Oh, I can't even vote for it. I mean, I'm not going to lie, dude. Queen Sugar sounds good. This Is Us sounds good.
They both
but
sound
I'm not
good.
Into dramas like that,
yeah,
man.
I don't, I'm not, just like there's this Netflix show with Regina King, 7 Seconds or something like that.
Okay, so that one's a little bit different.
But I know someone told me it's going to leave you angry. Almost.
Well, yeah, because it deals with cop relations and like and black people, and I get that.
Right.
But I feel like right now it's just so overloaded on everything having to have an agenda.
Right.
Or having some, like, push the conversation. Like, and I'm cool with that. But when I watch TV, I'm trying to tone some of that down for a minute.
Sometimes,
yeah. Social media, it's always in your face all the time.
Well, it didn't get renewed.
Huh?
It didn't get renewed.
Well, and there's a lot of people upset about that, but
like for well,
it's over one situation. Like
you, yeah, like that's what someone said.
Can't
like
just keep on like having that situation just drawn out. It's gonna get resolved. At least that's what the show is supposed to be about. And then people were upset like they could have found another situation to do. And like it's like yeah, but then the quality is gonna go down.
Right.
And unless sometimes you just gotta let something go out while it's on top. You know.
Excellent quote, Clinton. Yeah. But your scientists were so preoccupied over whether or not. They couldn't do that. They didn't stop to think if they should do that.
Yes.
In the first Jurassic Park.
Yeah. See, and that, but that's exactly how I feel about
science right now. Like,
I'm talking about like 7 Seconds. So yeah. Like, yeah, they could do another scenario, but they shouldn't because the show was great. Leave it at that. Sometimes you got to let things just be great and move on. That's how a lot of things, like messages, just get lost because you want to just keep on with it and just beating the dead horse
over and
over again.
But that's why I appreciate shows that get out fast. Like
The League. The comedy show The League.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, they went out right when it was, I think it was going to hit an inflection point, just go downhill.
Well, and see, to me, Penny Dreadful.
Mm-hmm.
Instead, it started rising. And it wasn't even starting to go down because you wanted to see more. You learned a whole lot that third season. It was like, yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
There's no more. We're done.
That's a great show that definitely did not do that would be House of Cards. Like,
well, I have friends that
they
say
went way too far.
I have friends that say the same thing about Sopranos.
Yeah, I've heard the same thing about Sopranos. I mean, I feel like there's very few shows that can run this long and not suffer from that. Like Simpsons. Simpsons is gone. I have actually watched some of the newer episodes of Simpsons. It's not bad.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not really big into cartoons anymore. Especially not that kind of humor, but
I mean, if
it was quality
if,
for what it was.
If I watch a cartoon, it's going to probably be Archer.
Yeah, but even with Archer, though, I think
it's ran too long. But yeah. I think this is the last season.
That would be good. You've heard of the show called Reboot? It's a cartoon.
Yeah.
And like they're inside of a computer.
Yeah.
So they redid it recently, and it's live action mixed with cartoon. It looks like Power Rangers, man.
Oh,
and that was like a really cool show. I know that's totally random, but I'm still upset about it. That's something I saw.
That was one of my favorite shows on like Saturday mornings.
Mm-hmm. But now Dominic came up to me and was like, yo, look at this show Reboot. And I was like, oh, yeah. Cartoon I used to watch when I was a kid. Nope. There was like a real person on there. I was like, what is this crap? And then Power Rangers looking lights popped on there. And then I heard somebody say, oh, this is Megabyte. And I was like, no, this is a shell of what it used to be.
Oh boy!
That's why I just watch trash TV now. I watch trash TV, or I watch stuff like Silicon Valley. And Billy. I actually finished watching Silicon Valley. That show is good.
Yeah.
Have you ever watched that on HBO?
I watched it the first season.
Yo, that shit is fire. They had 8 episodes this season, and I watched the finale today, and I was sitting there like, yes.
This weekend, I did the 80 movies marathon, which some will talk about after Facebook Live, and I binge watched Booze Traveler. Like, that's one of my new addictions now, just to see a guy go to different countries and get drunk off stuff he can't get in the U.S. I think that's so cool. Like,
yeah.
So he went to, was it Tanzania?
What's the weirdest thing he drank on there?
I can't say because it will spoil. I'll tell you after the show.
Is it like fermented piss?
It's actually something worse. And like when they brought it to him, he was like, you're fucking kidding me, right? That was his exact words.
Man, those shows, like, I watch those shows too, but they always come down to something with body fluids that's been fermented. Something he's like, all right, I get it. Like, you guys are isolated. This, that, and the other. But yeah.
But it'll be surprised because some of the places you would think you would hear stuff like that, they do stuff that just like, oh.
Bro, we got places here that eat mayonnaise and peanut butter sandwiches. Peanut butter and mayonnaise sandwiches
are
a real thing.
Yeah.
That's terrible. Miracle Whip is a real thing.
Yeah. And on that note.
That by far is the worst thing in the world.
We're going to bring this Facebook Live portion to a close. We ask that you subscribe to our show on all major platforms, including iTunes, SoundCloud, Google Play, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, and YouTube. I think I said that. If not, I said it again, YouTube. If you go on iTunes, make sure you give us a little feedback. You know, you drop us a line or two, tell us something you want us to check out. Like I said, I'm always up for a good movie marathon suggestion. Sometimes I just get bored. And I don't want to watch any shows and nothing like that. So definitely go to iTunes, give us some feedback on that. And if you're checking out this Facebook Live post, share it and the entire show with your family, with your friends on Facebook. Just tell them we do cuss. And lastly.
Or don't tell them.
Yes.
Because that would be fun.
That will be fun. Fuck, fuckity, fuck, fuck, fuck.
There you go.
Yes. Yeah. Donate. We need money. www.thesphere.tv/donate. You can do a single donation or you can go on a monthly subscription on Patreon. And that helps us do stuff like take you guys to the movies. We need some more feedback for you guys. We're trying to take you guys to the movies soon. Probably Jurassic World.
Maybe.
2. Or MI6. It's going to be something in June. MI6. It's going to be something in June. I'll tell you that right now. It has to be something so that all those are sequels.
Maybe if you guys donate enough money, we'll take you to one of the openings in Saudi Arabia of the new AMC movie theaters.
Right. And on that note.
Hey, man, if there's enough money coming in, you never know.
We're going to continue the show.
Got to dream big.
And make sure.
I'm going to go.
Make sure you check out the full episode when it drops.
I'm not going to go. Got no desire for that.
Yeah.
Actually, you know what's crazy is that we couldn't even get into the country. Like, if you go to Saudi Arabia, you can only stay in a compound unless you are from a Muslim nation out there.
Yeah.
So if you're American, you got to stay in the compound, which is like huge and great. It's nice and all that, but.
Yeah.
That's probably a movie theater there, though, actually.
Mm-hmm. Well, heck,
maybe I will do it.
Then they just showed the first movie in 17 years?
Yeah, it was Black Panther.
Yeah.
Yeah. But AMC. So I was looking at this because iPix sent me some info recently, like January. I guess they were going to do an IPO or something.
Yeah.
And it was about doing some investment into iPig. And yeah. I was like, that seems like a terrible investment right now to invest into a movie theater. And then let me down the rabbit hole finding out that AMC was like set to open like 15 or 20, maybe way more than that actually, but in Saudi Arabia. Because they haven't had movies since, I think, like the last 50 years. They were banned. And Black Panther was going to be the first movie that they showed in Saudi Arabia. In a movie theater. I was like, that's crazy. Absolutely. You think they would show that movie in a place where He's, by the way, he said emoji movie. Nah.
Our tech support, his name is Elijah.
Don't get your articles from The Onion.
We just got him down to Eli. I really don't want to go back to changing his name. Because he's been doing so good.
He who must not be named.
So good.
He's looking it up right now, I believe.
But, yeah, so I did the 80s movie marathon. I didn't post all of them. I only posted like two of them. But I ended up watching like seven 80s movies.
Mm-hmm.
Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Lost Boys.
So how was Lost Boys? I've never seen Lost Boys, and I really want to watch it.
It's, like, still, all it's still pretty good.
I know it had like an all-star cast in there.
Yeah. And then you got Corey Haim, Corey Feldman, Jason Patrick, Kiefer Sutherland, Jamie Gertz.
Vampires with mullets just sounds dope.
Yeah.
I've been watching a lot of True Blood lately, so.
After that fourth season of True Blood, I can't watch it anymore.
So what's funny is that True Blood around season five is actually pretty solid. Season six, when they start introducing this strange hybrid, that's when things... Like, there's an episode with where it starts talking about this dude named Warlow.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That's when shit gets a little like, oh, okay. You guys...
Yeah, you know, you're right. Yeah, you're right.
But, like, they got rid of... The one thing before that was really terrible was the Were-Panthers. And they killed those off rather quickly.
Really fast.
Thank God, because that shit was stupid. They were meth dealers, right. Inbreds, and they turned into panthers.
Right. I was like, bruh.
Like, I know on this show we talk about coming up with original content, but sometimes just stick to the old tried and true method. Werewolves, vampires, and then maybe one or two other types of things.
Or maybe just make them mountain lions. I mean, I won't be a bunch of meth dealers.
I don't, yeah. You don't have, don't mix both meth dealers and some new damn fucking. Right. I can't even curse right behind it. It was so bad.
All right. Oh, so Ferris Bueller, Lost Boys, Goonies, Weird Science. What other two I watched?
Out of all those movies, which would you say was the most overrated? Because you watched some pretty nostalgic movies.
Breakfast Club.
Oh, I hate that movie.
And
did you watch 16 Candles too?
No. So I've never been a fan of 16 Candles. Lucas.
I don't know Lucas.
That was a Corey Haim, Charlie Sheen movie.
So you've got Breakfast Club, you've got Lost Boys, you've got Ferris Bueller's Day Out, Weird Science. Of those movies. Oh, and Goonies, okay. So these are five really nostalgic movies that people always there's all in a group of 10, somebody over 30 is going to list one of these movies as their favorite movie.
Yeah.
Which one of these movies is overrated?
Breakfast Club.
Okay. We can continue the show. I feel the same way.
I mean, it's a decent movie,
mm-hmm.
but at the same time, compared to the others, when I watch Goonies, I want to grab a bowl of cereal and sit down in front of the TV.
Yeah.
Watching Ferris Bueller, I want to skip work.
Dude, Donkey Shed, like, that was still to this day one of my favorite scenes in any movie, period. The timeless movie.
And the art museums, it was a cool little
mm-hmm.
nonverbal scene.
And that little, that also has one of the creepiest scenes in a movie, period. When he comes up, he goes, picks up his girlfriend, and she's like, "Do you have a kiss for daddy?"
Yeah. Like, oh. I guess they kiss like that in their family.
Yeah, that was by far one of the weirdest scenes in a movie I've ever seen.
Yeah,
I think like, if I had a rank, that would be my top five.
I'm like, you scenes. Couldn't wait till you was out of school grounds.
Anything though, like just, do you have a kiss for daddy? What kind of creepy shit? Oh man, let's go ahead. Shout out to the Sphere, our home network. What's up? This portion of the show is sponsored by The Sphere. Are you starting your business and looking for a place to advertise? Do you have a need to reach out to thousands of people across the world to build your brand or sell your product? If so, get your product placement and advertising needs handled right here at The Sphere. We offer a wide variety of content delivery platforms, including iTunes, Google Play, SoundCloud, YouTube, and Stitcher. Plus, we have a vast demographic reach within the United States, as well as modern countries across the globe. Our enriched content and inspiring dialogue, coupled with your strategic ad, is surely to hit the mark every time. Call us today at area code 832-772-7789 or send an email over to advertise@thesphere.tv.
Dope.
Bada bing, bada boom.
Now, I might be doing next a 80s sci-fi fantasy marathon.
Well, we should look at. Sci-fi is good, but.
I have to include fantasy because I.
Movies, dude.
I want to put in like Kroll.
So I'm glad you said that because the ones I was saying of Kroll.
And
the toxic, what's that? That
toxic movie? Avenger.
The Toxic Avenger. Big Trouble in Little China.
Little China.
There's also.
And then, because I found out today, I think it's what, 32 years ago? No, 34 years ago or 35 was when Conan the Barbarian premiered.
Yeah.
In theaters was today.
And that's the only problem with these movies when I go back and watch them, because I used to love Conan the Barbarian.
I don't like.
They're such trash when you go back and watch
here's
them.
Here's the thing. I used to like, as a kid, I liked Conan the Destroyer more than I liked the Barbarian. Mm-hmm. But now, I love the Barbarian, and I can't stand the Destroyer. The one with Will Chamberlain.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Yeah, that one was pretty horrible.
It's like.
And Grace Jones.
Grace Jones is always such an incredible person to me.
She is.
Movies, because I'm always like in awe. Cause I just don't know what I'm always. I couldn't. If somebody asked you to describe Grace Jones, they're like, I can't. Whether it's
chaos,
hers Mayday,
chaos. That's what I would call her, chaos.
Yeah, I just don't get it, dude. But, I saw this article actually written about her about a couple months ago, and it was just talking about how. She literally embodies just doing whatever the hell she wants to do. It's crazy.
Nice. But yeah, so I'll probably do Conan, Kroll, The Last Starfighter, Tron.
The original Tron.
The original Tron, yeah.
The new one's trash. You ever heard of this movie called The Guyver? It's totally
yeah.
Okay.
It was made for TV.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Every time I hear Starfighter, I always think of the Guyver. And dude, I'm gonna rewatch I'm gonna go back and rewatch that movie soon because every year around the same time, like this time, it always pops back into my head.
Yeah,
and then it takes me like 3 days to remember what movie I'm talking about.
Well, now you got it on tape.
Golly. Oh fuck, right. But also, I got it saved now, so I'm about to. Yeah. dude. All right. So, minus all these 80s movies, Deadpool. We got a lot of good stuff coming up soon.
We do.
I'm pumped, man.
Deadpool, right after it, Solo.
Yeah.
And then one of our affiliate, you know, guests, he's normally on the Boom Bap. I'm trying to get him here one Monday. Grandfather Clock.
Okay.
He went to go see Solo tonight.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Well, earlier today, and he's like, I'm not going to tell you because I don't want to take away the feel of the movie when you see it. But I will see it again.
Perfect. But that doesn't really tell me anything, though. That doesn't mean if it's good or bad.
But.
Because, like, let's be real here. We've seen some movies that are trash that we went back to see again.
Yeah, but we went to go back to confirm that they were trash.
Mm-hmm.
So, he says, if you're a Star Wars fan, there's some stuff that happens that you don't expect in this. I said, bet.
So that'd be good because that was one of the things that I was worried about is that is it going to have a Star Wars feel? Because I'm sorry, but these new ones that we've talked about before,
the
they just don't feel like Star Wars movies.
The Last Jedi's got to be one of the worst. Like, as much as we rag on the prequels.
The prequels feel like Star Wars movies, though. Yeah. Just long-winded Star Wars movies.
Yeah.
They're like documentaries.
Yeah.
But Darth Maul was like one of the coolest villains, period.
Yeah, with no screen time.
Yeah, like. None of the villains in these new ones even feel like villains to me.
They don't.
They just feel like babies. And then Snoke, who could have been a great villain, well, dead.
Dead. All right, let's get to this trailer. And this is a...
I'm flabbergasted.
Reboot, remake, I don't know what you want to call this.
It is a reboot.
Reboot, okay.
Yeah, because it doesn't really feel like a remake. I mean, because the settings are different, you know?
Well, it seems like it's a continuation or something almost.
Yeah, because they've mentioned... An upgrade. And like
yeah.
The originals were in the jungle.
Right.
And these dudes are in the suburbs. Guys, we're talking about Predator.
Yes.
It started off reminded me of like Halloween.
Right. I'm like, you got kids for Halloween walking around, this little kid opening this box.
Like, you know something's up when it's Halloween, everyone's trick or treating and this dude's opened up mysterious packages still dressed up as like a fifth grade substitute science teacher.
Right. He starts touching shit. And
he's
shit.
Got the Infinity Gauntlet right there.
Power Stone.
Some Jenga. I think he's playing Jenga wrong. I've always been a fan of like the newer Predator movies. Well, we talked about that. Minus Requiem. Like, AVP was dope.
Yeah, AVP was dope. And this looks pretty good to me.
What's that John Travolta knockoff of this movie with him and Forrest Whitaker? His pan is one of being one of the worst movies of all time.
Battlefield Earth.
Godly, yeah. When I was younger, before I knew anything really about movies, I thought that it was going to have something to do with this because they kind of looked like the people from Predator.
It did.
But that movie was like, super trash.
I was a kid and I knew that shit was garbage.
Bro, that movie and then Ultraviolet are two of the most trash movies I've ever seen.
Now, what I'm interested in is a lot of the cast here are people you've seen before, but no major stars. Maybe Olivia Munn.
I didn't even realize she was in there, so.
But
it's good, though. And this just goes in the same vein that we've been talking about, where it's like we're at that point where there's a transition of, like, all the old action heroes and actors that we grew up with are basically transitioning to this new school.
Yeah.
Chapter of characters.
And it's time. It's needed.
And I really like not seeing the same action hero characters on the same screen, on the big screen. Like, seeing some newer, some fresh blood in there.
Definitely.
Hopefully, these dudes aren't trash. But when we saw with, like, oh boy who plays Newt in Fantastic Beasts, that was a good move.
Yeah.
Having somebody completely unknown.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he wasn't unknown.
Well, he's been in some other movies, but he's not played like that. He played Stephen Hawking.
Yeah, but I mean, heck, he got him an Oscar, so.
But he wasn't an action hero.
No.
He was quirky, though.
I can't even call him an action hero in Fantastic Beasts, though. He's more of an adventure.
Action / adventure.
Okay, yeah.
Let's do that. Because he's definitely kicking ass in, like, especially in this new one. Him and his brother are fighting.
Yeah, but when I say action, I think more of the more physical part.
Mm-hmm. He does fly on some, like, magic beast. And wrestles with a giant rhino with glowing forehead. I mean, I guess that's kind of adventurous.
Yeah.
And action-packed. Oh, man. Let's shout out one of our sponsors. This portion of the show is sponsored by KOG and Company. Are your unique gifts and talents changing the world? Unleash Your Dopeness is a people empowerment movement built to encourage the masses to operate outside of their fears and have the gall to recklessly pursue their dreams and passions in life. Join thousands of others as we unlock the greatness that dwells inside. Shop dope gear at kogpassion.com. That's kogpassion.com. And use coupon code DOPE for 10% off exclusive Unleash Your Dopeness apparel. Act now. Sizes are selling out fast.
They just made two discoveries. I'm not sure if you guys were aware of this, but they're making a new Return to Elm Street and a Purge 4.
Purge 4 we definitely knew about. It's supposed to be like an origin story.
Yeah, it's the Purge origin.
Return to Elm Street, I didn't know about, though. I didn't either. That's pretty cool.
I hope it's
maybe. I mean,
although I won't lie, I didn't necessarily dislike the reboot. I didn't necessarily dislike it.
I just think Freddy Krueger was a little bit played out and overrated. I'd like them to do Hellraiser or Candyman.
Candyman would be dope.
Hellraiser or Candyman, I think, is an easily overlooked but underrated horror movie.
Mahershala Ali as the new Candyman. Because he's got the voice.
He just doesn't strike fear in my heart.
Well, no one saw him as a criminal until he did Cottonmouth on Luke Cage.
But even then, though, like, I can see him, like, I couldn't even see him playing, like, a really sadistic criminal. Because even Cottonmouth wasn't that sadistic. Like, he was a villain for sure, but
yeah.
Gangster. Like, I've seen him playing a gangster role. Like, he played that one well.
Yeah.
But seeing him playing someone sadistic, like,
I think he could probably do it.
Not saying that he doesn't have the chops to do it.
Yeah.
It's just, I don't think it's a role that fits him. Like, his demeanors and all that. Like, I think, damn, I don't know who could play Candyman, though. Because old boy that played Candyman originally, he's creepy.
Yeah.
Like, he's a creepy person.
True.
But I can't think of any, like, black actors who I would see playing. You know who would be funny to play that role, though? Fucking Wesley Snipes. But I don't know any. We don't have too many creepy. But this, first of all, there's not that many creepy actors now, period. There's a handful of them, and they get all the creepy roles, but what's that? I'm going to figure out the dude's name, too, because he was an interesting character, period.
The actor who played him?
Yeah.
Tony Todd?
Because he's always had kind of a creepier...
I think it's Tony Todd or something like that.
Yeah, Tony Todd. Even like in his old photos, like him nowadays, he just comes off as creepy. He's played in nothing, like even when he was in Final Destination, when he was like giving all the warnings,
the mortician,
creepy as shit.
Well, he was a mortician,
but he just has that air of creep around him, you know.
Yeah.
Like you think of Denzel Washington, you're gonna think of somebody smooth. Like Morgan Freeman, you think of someone who's gonna talk to you, but it's gonna relax you. You're like, oh, I just want to listen to this. This person talk.
You would think that T said he wanted when Morgan Freeman said, but even, shoot this motherfucker.
Even then, though, like, he had the range to do it, but throughout the whole movie in general,
he
was easily persuading you, like, oh, yeah.
Oh,
let me just talk to me. Like, yeah.
That's
okay.
Still one of my favorite parts of the whole movie.
Yeah.
Shoot this motherfucker.
But you couldn't see him, like, say, like, do something creepy. It was like, all right, let's peel this dude's skin off. Like, you're not going to see nothing creepy like that. I still think Hellraiser, though, right now would be a smash hit because, dude, the Cenobites on screen with better, like, CGI and shit.
True.
As long as they didn't rely too heavily on it. Because even then, that was by far one of the creepiest opening scenes. And that very first one where the dude opens up that box and just gets ripped apart.
Yeah.
One of the most gruesome scenes. Period.
I don't know. I probably would say Hellraiser with you.
Yeah. But even though we got off topic, Predator, the new Predator looks kind of like it's going to be pretty solid.
Yeah,
though. And the thing that I like is that they're doing a reboot of this, and I'm kind of going to be ranking the way this one does, kind of how Venom is, because we're familiar with the character, but it's a retelling of the story or a different type of story for the same character that we're familiar with. It seems to go a little bit out of the cookie cutter. For this person, so it's gonna be.
I think this is more of a continuation than anything. I don't think this is a retelling.
I guess we'll see. Yeah. I just hope they don't rely too much on CGI.
It doesn't look like it.
Yeah. I know. Purge 4. We don't have a. There's not a trailer out for that though. There is.
Yeah.
Man, that's what I saw this.
We're making a trailer for next week.
Yeah, we should, because that's one of my favorite. Series of movies right now.
Yeah.
Boy, you look like you're about to just kill over it.
I'm sick and tired. And it's starting to get hot in here now.
Bro, yeah, we're cooking up in here.
So, that is our cue, people. Thanks for checking out this show.
Isaac's over there happy.
We're going to go ahead and get on out of here. Definitely check us out next week to talk about Deadpool. As usual, the first half of the show will be spoiler-free. Second half is fuck it.
God, Lee, I'm so excited about Deadpool. I'm happy it's finally fucking out.
Me too.
I just hope it's not a letdown. When were the pre-screenings? You know? I'm about to see if there's any. It's Monday, though, so they're probably not
out. Well, I know it was premiering tonight. The world premiere was tonight.
Let's see if there's any.
So, it's time for me to stay off the internet for a while.
I don't really
care too much for Deadpool. But we'll be talking about that next week. We'll have some more trailers for you, some more shows. I'm gonna try to finish Lost in Space by then.
I actually forgot all about it.
Because it's gonna get picked. It is getting picked up for a second season.
So how far into it are you?
Like 4 episodes.
Oh damn! So you wouldn't have the answer then. I was trying to guess if it's a parallel universe game they're playing yet, or if it's in the future that when they go into that area, because you know, like the old one was
ultimately. I won't know yet, but we'll see. And thanks for checking us out. Make sure you check out a bunch of good movies and good shows. Well, let us know what you watch, what you think, and until then, zip it up and zip it out.
What was that from?
Dave Chappelle.
Oh, yeah.